George Monk was born a leader of men, who swore to serve his king to the end. Though even before Charlie's head hit the floor, George was knocking at Fairfax's door.
With glory there comes booty, for the love of a fair day's pay. If your troops to command, he'd lend you a hand. George Monk was a practical man.
When the Second War came, George Monk found fame from Ireland to Dunbar, leading Cromwell's men as advisor and friend. Soon George was a general again.
With glory there comes booty, for the love of a fair day's pay. If your troops to command, he'd lend you a hand. General Monk was a practical man.
The fleet set sail under Admiral Monk, and to fight Van Tromp did go. Although he didn't know his port from his bow, George still made a profitable show.
With glory there comes booty, for the love of a fair day's pay. If your ship's to command, he'd lend you a hand. Admiral Monk was a practical man.
The Protector died, and from Richard's side, General Monk saw they were through. He didn't lose any sleep with the States to upkeep. What else could poor George do? General Monk proclaimed Prince Charles as king, and his troops controlled the town. The monarchy restored and a peerage assured, loyal men earn rich rewards.
With glory there comes booty, for the love of a fair day's pay. If your troops to command, he'd lend you a hand. George Monk was a practical man. General Monk was a practical man. Lord Monk was a practical man.